here with our men's basketball weekly update with head coach TJ Otzelberger. First things first, let's recap the Summer League tournament down at Sioux Falls. Survive and advance that first day against Western Illinois, a 66-60 win. Down at halftime, came back and got the win. Mike Dom really carried you down the stretch there, and survive and advance was the story there.
Yeah, I think Coach Wright at Western did a great job. They were really prepared for us. They switched a lot of screens, put us on our heels. Thought offensively we were settling a little bit for shots from the perimeter, that we didn't get great ball movement. Fortunate we stuck with it, stayed together, and late in the game we were able to make our run and push through for the victory.
Monday, rival NDSU, they changed some things up, but David Jenkins got hot, and Mike Dom was obviously very good again once again. 78-57 win, and you got the championship Tuesday.
Yeah, we have a lot of respect for the Bison, and they've been a great program. I think we've had some tough-fought battles with them this year. Going into halftime, I really liked our aggressiveness, especially defensively. Thought our effort was tremendous. They came out of halftime playing really five-guard lineup, trying to space and drive the ball, and got them back into the game, and then we were able to kind of go inside into the paint, and Mike scored the ball, and David, whether it was getting to the rim or the three-point line, and we're able to have a great defensive effort, which is why we came out with the victory.
Tuesday for all the marbles against South Dakota, 97-87 win. Mike Dom goes out in that first half, but you actually built a bigger lead and got that cushion you maybe needed in that second half. 97-87 win, dance for the third straight year.
We've got a lot of character on our team, a lot of guys that can step up on a given night. And Mike didn't play that last 11 and a half minutes of that first half, and we went from being down one to up 12. So it speaks a lot to the guys on our team. Brandon Key was tremendous during that stretch. David Jenkins stepped up. Lane Severn was great. And Flatten and Tellinghues, and those five guys pretty much carried us with Mike and Tevin in foul trouble. And I think it really gave us a lot of momentum going into halftime. I think the pace of the game was really fast and tough for them to keep up. And our guys just kept the foot on the gas coming out of the locker room starting the second half. I thought defensively we were good. Mike had some shots early, and we really got rolling and went from there.
You've talked all season long about playing together, and any given night guys need to step up when their number is called. I thought that tournament was probably as good as an example of that all season long.
Yeah, I think when you have three games in 4 days, it's going to be a lot of different guys that you need to call on and need to answer the bell. And I think that was definitely evident, certainly stood out, that last 11 and a half minutes of that first half against USD when both Tevin and Mike were in foul trouble. So we've said it. We've got a team that has depth. We've got a team that can go big, that can go small. We've got different guys that can step up. We can beat you where Mike has 30 points, and we can beat you where seven guys are in double figures. So really credit to our guys, their togetherness and unity, because it's a team effort every night out.
A three-peat for the program, second straight for you, cutting the net for second straight year. What was that like for you?
It is a great feeling. We have had a target on our back all through league play and through the conference play. Our guys have performed at a high level, won a lot of games, and every night out, teams are gunning for you. And then, to go on the road and do what we're able to do in league play on the road is really impressive. And then carry that over down at the Denny, and just really proud of our guys, their focus they have every night out.
What's this week been like for you with all the media attention and taking care of business? I'm sure it's been a hectic week for you in this program.
Try to do the best you can, staying in your normal schedule and routine. Last week we wanted to get our guys some rest, but we practiced towards the end of the week. Yesterday we find out, just like everybody does, when your name's called on Sunday. And then for us, it's a lot of preparation, a lot of film breakdown, scouting reports and things, trying to get a great handle on Ohio State, what makes them such a great team, and what things that we can feel like we can be successful with against them. So a lot of film breakdown and get to the practice floor and prepare just like we do every game.
I'm sure it's still early and you're still taking a look at things and how Ohio State looks, your draw against the 5 seed there. What do you see out of them so far out of the film breakdown?
Yeah, I think they're a team that's very physical. They're a great rebounding team. They're a physical defensive team as well as offensively. They'll post a lot of guys. Kate's D up. Their leading scorer is a versatile 6'7", 230-pound forward. He can play the 3, the 4. He can post. He can score away from the basket. He's really a challenging matchup. And then Tate, guy for them who's about 6'4", about 230, 240. He just plays a lot of different positions. He's a challenging matchup. So A team that, you know, when you go 15-3 in the Big Ten, it says a lot. It says a lot about their program and the type of team they have and the year that they had. So a lot of respect for them, and know it's going to be a very formidable matchup.
Fair to say that offensively they're pretty efficient, defensively they're solid, and they really just rebound the ball really, really well.
Yeah, they're a good team all the way around. There's not any glaring weaknesses. They're a group that is tremendous on the glass on both sides. So we're going to have to keep them off the offensive boards, and we're going to have to try to make sure we do what we can on the offensive glass to try to get some extra possessions as well. But we realize they're very effective there, and it's going to take tremendous effort, team effort. But I think our guys are up for the challenge.
You've been coaching a while. Fair to say that this tournament is all about teams getting hot and any given night, especially in the NCAA tournament. And, you know, the Jackrabbits might be due for one of those.
Yeah, anything can happen. We're fortunate to have guys that have been on this stage, a lot of guys for 3 years, guys that aren't content just being here, guys that, you know, are a point where our program is, where it's time for us to step up and get a win. And that's how our guys feel. That's the feeling in our locker room. So hopefully it can be very detail-oriented, very fundamentally sound, and come out and play with great confidence and do what we need to do come Tuesday afternoon.